Welcome back to Mechanical Pros. My name is Josh. I'll be going over the basic navigation of the BRC1E73 navigation remote, otherwise known as the NavStat. Today we'll dive a little deeper into service menus and maintenance menus. So to get into the service menus, we're going to simply light up the screen as it is here and hold down the cancel button. Now we're into a new menu called the service settings menu. So you'll see a plethora of different settings. Primarily what we live in the commission and startup world is the field settings, which is where we're going to basically tell the unit what thermistor to operate to, whether or not we want to control the fan on thermo on or off, meaning when it's done satisfying the space temperature, is it going to shut that fan off or leave it on? And then we can also tell the thermostat or tell the unit with the thermostat what thermistor we want to control the temperature to. Do we want to use the thermostat thermistor or do we want to use the return air thermistor? Most of the time when we have these installed on the wall, this is the location we're going to want to control the temperature to because of height differences and such. Heat is always stored higher up in the space than at the thermostat level. We also have an energy savings options, which is essentially a set point range limitation, what we call it. So we can go in there and basically regulate where, you know, how far your cooling set point can go down and how high up your heating set point can go. Now, most of that's going to be done through an iTouch manager controller, which is essentially a centralized control that will do that for the whole building. But if you don't have that type of control, you can always do it through the thermostat. We also have prohibit functions in here, so we can actually prohibit what buttons and modes we can use through this specific thermostat or individual thermostat. Another important one on commissioning is going to be group addressing and indoor airnet addressing. And why that's important is because when we start up and commission a building, we'll have anywhere from, you know, 500 to 800 indoor units. Each of them can have their own individual control like this, and each of them also have to have a specific address, i.e. a name, to go to it. So when we pull it into an iTouch controller, we know what unit that is. So for a service standpoint, that's extremely important because if you're on a site and you have your service tool hooked up, we don't see the names that are associated with that unit. All we see is the group address. So if you wanted to come in and find the group address of the unit that's kind of having some problems, you can find that in the service settings menu under group address unit, and you'll see the group address populated here on the screen. You can also see the airnet address of the specific unit going into the indoor unit airnet address menu, and the address will populate here. We can also see error history of the specific indoor unit and also the indoor unit status. And what the indoor unit status is helpful for in service is if we had this unit in the cooling mode, we essentially have on this one, it will populate 6 different thermistor readings. Again, determining what type of model unit you have. You can have different thermistors. In this case, the main ones what we're gonna look at are TH2 and TH3. TH2 is what we call the liquid pipe thermistor, and TH3 is what we call the gas pipe thermistor. Why those two are really important is because the liquid pipe thermistor is actually bringing in the cooled down liquid from the condenser outside. So we wanna see what that temperature is doing. If it's, you know, in the 40s, 50 degree area, then that means it's usually in cooling mode, and our gas thermistor should follow with about 10 degrees difference, determining we're actually transferring heat. A good thing about this is that you can actually see if your indoor unit's not actually cooling, and you come up here to this menu, and if I had some skewed numbers like 40 degrees on TH2 and 50 degrees on TH3, and we're not moving any air, that means we actually have what we would call liquid bleed by through the valve, and that's not good. That's how we destroy compressors on VRV equipment, and it's not going to be a good day. We can also see if we go into the maintenance menus, which we will hold down the cancel button again within the service settings. Now we're in the maintenance menu where we can see the model name of the specific indoor unit. So in this case we have an FXFQ24TVJU. We can see the another indoor unit status menu here, which will actually populate if our fan is on or off, what speed it's running, what position the flaps are in, what position the EEV is in, whether or not our mechanical pump or our condensate pump is in, if we had an electric heater on here, whether it's on or off, humidifier on or off, or TBF is on or off. And then also here is another sensor value list where we can actually see on older systems, older VRV systems, they don't really populate within the service menu of the indoor unit status. So if we come down here to the maintenance menu and see address sensor value, we can click in there and we'll see unit number, code, and data. So the unit number is something like if we had anywhere from 1 to 16 indoor units on one thermostat, we can scroll through which unit we want to see data on. And then we'll scroll over to the code, which is going to be the thermistor number. So we know before TH2 and TH3 are liquid and gas piped. So we want to scroll up to code 2, which will populate our liquid thermistor reading. And in the data, it's actually going to show it to you in Celsius. So here we're at 27 degrees Celsius on the liquid. And if we go up to code 3, which will be our gas thermistor, we're also at 27 degrees Celsius. So that tells me that the outdoor unit's not running, or if it was a multi-port system, something like that, we're not feeding refrigerant through this coil. So what I have here is basically the same remote, verbatim, except what I've done is I've attached some 18-2 stranded wire to it. And this is because I utilize this as a tool. So if I'm going into a hotel setting to start up or commission a system, they're going to use something that's going to accommodate their hotel system, like Honeywell, so it's all integrated into the same system. What I do is I basically plug this in to the unit, give it a group address, an internet address, and then set all my settings according to what that specific job calls for. Thank you for watching this episode of Mechanical Pros. I hope this video was informative and helpful. We'll see you on the next one.